story behind Tartu street art?
There's a legend that actually perhaps started even here, because the bridge was built in 2009. And of course, I cannot tell you when did the movement started. It's impossible to tell you. But I've heard stories that there was this one work on that side, I think. And then some people who were really interested in street art and who had just been to Berlin, which is like super inspirational always to street art lovers, then they saw the work and thought that, ah, there's so much concrete in here, it's so gray, let's do something about the bridge. And it was the first like melting pot in Tartu, because everyone, like, the word started spreading around, people started coming here during nighttime, everyone added something, there was a dialogue between artists. It was super, super interesting because many people pass under the bridge when we go home, so they can see new works popping up and some of them being buffed or written over, so it's an ongoing process.
Is the making of street art legal in Tartu?
No. No, it's not. You can get a fine, indeed. Yeah.
How long have you organized street art festival Stencibility here in Tartu?
In Tartu, we started 1 year after it was started, actually. So the first festival was in Tallinn during the cultural... it was the time when Tallinn was the cultural capital of Europe, so it was 2011, I think.
How tourists can find street art in Tartu?
I guess the easiest way is to go to our website, which is www.stencibility.eu. And from there you can see our Facebook, Instagram, you can get all the contacts, and we're very open to making street art tours. So for example, if someone writes to me that we have a group of 10 people or 5 people, whatever, and we would like to see the street art of Tartu, so I'm more than pleased to come and make you a tour of a couple of hours by bike or by foot, doesn't matter to me. So this work here is done by Edward van Lungus, who is the most notorious stencil artist in Estonia, and I think the Finnish audience also probably recognizes him because his works are now in many different capitals of Europe, definitely in Helsinki, Copenhagen, Rome. Now they will go to Paris because of the 100th birthday of Estonia. But what I really like about this art piece is that it's super Estonian. It's about Kalevipoeg, who has been turned into a robot. And there's actually the little hedgehog there who is controlling Kalevipoeg. You can see the little hedgehog there. But, you know, street art is never controlled, so you never know who wants to get into dialogue with you. So in that case, there has been another artist who has decided to paint it over a bit. And you can see that it almost seems like Kalevipoeg has chopped off the guy's head. And I know that the local one journalist asked the artist, Edward van Lungus, what do you think about it? Like, are you a bit mad because someone painted over your work? And he was like, no, it's really fun. This is what street art is about. It's about dialogue. So this work here, the original art piece is done by Kondas, who is a naivist Estonian painter. And one street artist called Sorro, you can see the signature here with a cat, took this original naivist work and made it into a stencil. So it was many, many years ago, and this artist Sorro used to make other stencils also based by Estonian classics. Journey to the
Main. There's a huge Einstein mural behind you. Tell me, how is it done?
It's done with spray printer, and it's a totally unique new technology that uses spray paint and wall climbing robots.
And is there other spray print work outside Estonian?
Yep, now our headquarters is in Silicon Valley in California, and most of the prints we are doing are there.
Is it possible to buy a spray printer for yourself?
Yes, there are two versions. One is the handheld version for like everyone to use in their own home, and the other is the wall climbing robot that you can order as a service.